After months of politics, the dust has begun to settle. Expectations are high among ordinary citizens that President Julius Maada Bio will deliver on his promises.
Look at the health centers, because when you go to a hospital now, you have nothing like that, like any facilities in the hospital now. Number two, to look at them, that those people, these corruption people.
The election has left a polarized country in its wake.
The election left us with a polarized society, meaning we are divided along political line, I wouldn't say ethnic line, but regionally correct. So we need to have a president who can unite us. We need a united force.
Outgoing President Ernest Bai Koroma steps down after a decade in power. He will be remembered for maintaining peace after the civil war.
So issues around national inclusion, issues around ensuring that everyone becomes part of government, not a southeastern government, a northern government, or a western government.
Extreme poverty remains pervasive in Sierra Leone. The country ranks near bottom in international rankings for health, education, and development. Corruption among government officials is endemic.
The most important area of work that is needed by the current administration is the fight against corruption. There were big scandals on Ebola, the mudslide funds that were people felt were chopped. And because of that, we saw about 20% of votes in the western area that was lost by the ruling party.
Expectations are that Maada Bio will turn the country around within months and provide jobs for the overwhelmingly young people. But peace and stability remains the biggest concerns.
The new president sets out to name his cabinet. Many Sierra Leoneans are keen. They want a government of national inclusion, one that is independent of political party affiliations in order to restore national cohesion and bring about development. Susan Mwongeli, CGTN in Freetown, Sierra Leone.